What's going on, my dudes? Welcome to the channel. I'm Quitty Bags, and today, my dudes, I'm going to be teaching you how to find an ocean monument in Minecraft. Now, this is pretty simple, but it can be tricky sometimes because sometimes you go into the ocean and you expect to find one, but you just don't find one. And trust me, we all know I've done that. If you've watched my live hardcore series, it took me a long time to find one. So I'm going to be teaching you how you can actually find one using cartographer villagers in Minecraft. So let's get into this. Now, before we do, don't forget to smash that like button. Also, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit sub to become one of the dudes. And also, we're on the road to 40,000 subscribers, and I could use every single one of my dudes that watch this video's help. So make sure to smash that sub button if you enjoy my content. All right, let's get started. All right, so the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to find a village exactly like this. We just found ourselves a village, and we're going to need some villagers. So we're going to go look around for a villager, and once we find a villager, I will show you the next step here. All right, we got a ton of villagers here. This is good. It's not an abandoned village. The next thing we're going to need is some sugarcane to make two pieces of paper, and then we're going to need four planks of wood. All right, so let's go get those supplies. All right, so I managed to gather up all these supplies we actually need. As you guys can see, let's put down our crafting table here, and we're going to make three pieces of paper like this using three pieces of sugarcane, and then we're gonna place two pieces of paper over top and a 2 1x2 like that, and then we're gonna place a 2x2 of planks, and boom, we got the cartography table. So now, using this cartography table, we're gonna walk up to a villager, and we're gonna place it. Now, one of these dudes should become a cartographer. There we go. He's the cartographer. All right. So now you can see here, we got some trades going. This guy wants 24 pieces of paper for emeralds, and he wants 7 emeralds for empty map. Basically, we need to get his level from novice. We need to upgrade his level. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to get some more paper, and we're also going to get some emeralds, and we're going to do some trading with him. So then we can actually get a better map from him, because we're actually going to buy an Ocean Explorer map from him. So let's go ahead and do that now. All right, I stumbled upon a ridiculous amount of paper and some emeralds. I'm just kidding. I obviously just spawned it in. But anyways, we're going to show you guys doing some trades with this villager here, getting him from a novice. So now that his bar went all the way up, we're going to wait a second here. Wait for those purple little swirly things to come off him. That means he should have leveled up now. And now he is an apprentice. So this is pretty cool. So now, as an apprentice, as you guys can see here, he has the Ocean Explorer map. So what we're going to do now is we need to get him one compass and 12 emeralds. Luckily, we have lots of emeralds here. Now we're just going to have to get a compass and we'll be good to go. So we're going to need some redstone and some iron. All right, I got some redstone and some iron. We're going to put the iron in this formation and then put the redstone right in the middle, and boom, we got ourselves a compass. Now we're going to go back to the cartographer, and we are going to trade our one compass and 12 emeralds for an Ocean Explorer map. Boom, there we go. Okay, so now we have this map, and as you guys can see, it definitely shows in the kind of the right side of the map, middle map there. You can see that is the ocean monument we want to find. So, but we can see on the top right of the map there, there's a little circle, and that is us. And we need to get all the way down to the ocean monument. Now, this isn't very hard. It's pretty simple. We're going to hit F3 on Java Edition right now. And you're going to see we are facing, if you look at the left side, underneath block chunk, it'll say facing. And we are facing east. But right now, we need to go southwest. So we're going to turn, and we are facing west now. So we could go all the way west if we'd like and aim southwest. So if we aim southwest, eventually we will end up at this ocean monument. So let's start heading this way and see if we can find this place. Now, some of these are really far away. It might be good to have an elytra, a horse, you know, a pig with a saddle. Just kidding, that would take a long time. But these are going to be pretty far away. So I'll show you dudes when we start getting close. All right, so I've went west quite a bit, and you can actually see my character on the screen is actually starting to move. On the map, sorry, is actually starting to move there. So now, because we've went west quite a bit, we're going to want to go south now. So let's line ourselves up for south, and that is south. So let's go this way. So if you know how to read a compass, you basically know how to follow a map in Minecraft. It's pretty simple. All right, now I've been going south for quite some time, as you guys can see, and we're coming up to the Ocean Monument. Now, another thing I didn't mention, you can actually put your map in your offhand, and it makes it a little bit easier so it's not so big and bulky there. So as you dudes can see, it seems we're coming up to the Ocean Monument in just a few minutes here. And it should be right up here. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can see it. Oh, there it is. All right. So we found the Ocean Monument. And that is exactly how to find it. Now, these things are pretty dangerous and pretty hard to beat the Elder Guardians. There's Guardians and Elder Guardians down in these things. Now, I really recommend you have a full kit of armor, a trident, and some other stuff. Because these guys are going to be a little bit difficult to kill. But as you can see, we actually made it to the Ocean Monument. So we've made it through using the map. The map's pretty simple to use. Right now I'm on peaceful mode, so there's going to be no Elder Guardians. But the map is pretty simple to use. And then now you're good to go to explore this Ocean Monument, my dudes. Alright, my dudes, that's going to be it for this video. That is exactly how to find an ocean monument in Minecraft, the easiest way. Now, if you just take a boat out or an elytra and fly around over top of an ocean, you should be able to find it without actually getting an explorer map. But sometimes it's actually pretty difficult and you don't find one. And it's kind of like frustrating because they're usually very simple to find. But it's all on your seed. And, you know, if your seed doesn't generate them quite a bit, then you won't find them. So if you dudes enjoyed this video, make sure to smash like for me. Also, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to smash that sub button. We're on the road to 40,000 dudes, so that is absolutely amazing, and I would love to see you become one of the dudes. All right, thank you for watching, and I will see you dudes in the next video. If you want me to actually make a video about how to raid an ocean monument, drop it in the comment section, and I would love to do that and show you the best gear and everything you need to raid these things, because they can be very dangerous, and I'm not kidding about that. So let me know in the comment section if you want to see that, and I will see you dudes in the next Minecraft video. Peace out.